this, because, you know, this is my mom. But you know, I'm happy. I'm celebrating her life today. And I don't want any tears. I just want you to remember Mom and some of the things she used to do. So a few of my friends and family gave me some definite memories that she remembers. Mom lived very close to here in Lancaster, and she walked a lot. So one day she was walking by this friend's house and noticed there was a flat of flowers sitting there that were probably in need of some water, if I'm guessing. And she went home from her walk. She grabbed her tools. She went back over to her house, and she planted her flowers. Now that's my mother. For once, she's nosy. But she did so much for other people. She loved flowers. She loved gardening. Another lady that lived across the street when we were growing up, she was a good family friend. Jan's little, I don't know, partner in crime. her memory back to me was not only the scones that Mom always made, but it was the crocheting. I don't know how many of us kids she tried to get us to crochet. Well, come over here and sit down. And she'd give us yarn, she'd give us needles, and boy, you do this and this and this, and then you flip that, and we were constantly saying, we're never gonna make this, Mom. But you know, she tried with every one of us, and that was Sylvia's memory of my mom. One of Craig and I's favorite memories of Mom. I worked at Target. I was getting out of work right around dinner time. She came in to see me. She says, Craig and I are gonna go over to Chi-Chi's and we'll meet you there. I said, okay, I'll be there in about half hour, blah, 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 blah. I get there, I cannot find them. They're not at a table, they're not in the van. So the guy looks at me and says, did you check in the bar? And I'm like, no, she wouldn't go in the bar. And there she is with my son, probably 11 maybe, sitting in there eating chips and salsa with her Coke and Craig's Coke. And I'm like, you took my son to the bar. She just thought that was funny. They probably all know that she loved Mexican. That woman could eat a jar of salsa and she didn't like to share. So never share Mexican with anybody in my family because we're not very good at sharing. One of the things I really thought was a good memory was Aunt Virgie. We all know Aunt Virgie. Well, Aunt Virgie and Mom, with whatever day Survivor was on TV, they would call each other about 5 minutes before the show started. They talked for about 10 minutes after the show started, but they had to hang up and watch, and then they called each other back to talk about what happened. Now that's gotta be one of the best sister moments ever. In my last memory, my mom, I came over and Amanda was there with her friend Mackenzie, and I said, hey, I'm bringing stuff over. And I dressed up, I had a hat, and I had weird clothes on, and I didn't match, and I brought my tea set. And we had a tea party. So Mom says, I'm gonna go get dressed too. So she comes out, she's got this, her hair in some amazing way. She's got red lipstick up to her nose and around. And the picture, I'm like, smile, and she's going, that's Mom. So as you step through this, please remember those moments that Grandma just did the most amazing things. Remember those scones that we got to eat every time she said, no, I'm not making bread to make scones. But she did anyhow. After the service, we are having a little small thing out at Kirk and I's house. If you need our address, I'm more than willing to give it to you. And I'll even tell you the correct one. But we just want to share those memories. We want to remember her in that happy spot and celebrate her life. So thank you all for coming.
In the life-giving waters of baptism, our sister Dolores died with Christ Jesus so that she can also rise with him to eternal life. And on that same day of her baptism, Dolores clothed herself in Christ. When the Lord comes again, may she be clothed in glory.
The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. None of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. For we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then, each of us shall give an account to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
But they're not sad because they realize that their loved one is no longer struggling or suffering. And then every once in a while, there's also some pretty interesting sharing that happens. Memories and anecdotes and things that are helpful for someone like me to be able to talk to you all. Well, Jan and Lori were pretty delightful when they were here the other day, because they talked about their mom like a mom who had little quirks every once in a while, but who they loved deeply. And they knew her story. They clearly talked to their mom enough. They knew what her childhood was like in great detail. And they recognized that it's that stuff that formed this person they called mom. So there are a few things that are central to what I know about her. I know it's Dolores with an O, not an E. I know that in her later years, you probably didn't want to have dinner that she made. But I also know that there were things she did without even recognizing them, I'm sure, for her part, that were very much like things that Jesus did. Caring for others and reaching out when others were in need. Knowing what's going on in other people's lives, not to be nasty about it, but out of concern and care. But one that was even more subtle, they told me that she used to make this fried heart attack in a pan, is the best way I could describe it. I think scones, is it what you call it? And it was a bread that not only did the family share in, but clearly friends and neighbors learned when that was happening because they really enjoyed it. And this is where I say, without her even knowing about it, that is very much an image of Eucharist, of being in communion with one another. Because Jesus took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his friends as a way of being one with him and a way of remembering. And clearly, without her knowing, she did that for many of you as a way of being one with you. But clearly also as a way of remembering, because that memory came out loud and clear. And there's one last thing that was shared that I want to share with you to conclude. And I can't help but think that when Jesus came to welcome her into all life, to the kingdom prepared for her from the foundation of the world, the response she had back when the Lord says, "Do you want to come be here with me always?" was just, "Let me get my shoes on." Friends, I invite you, if you would please stand as we turn to God with our prayers of petition. Our response will be, "Lord, have mercy."
In baptism, Dolores received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death, we pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Our sister Dolores was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her to the halls of the heavenly banquet, we pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son, we pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Dolores' family and friends seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. we pray.
Lord, have mercy.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Dolores. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Friends, gathering these and all of our prayers that remain in the silence of our hearts, we pray using the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope that one day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Dolores in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Friends, because God has chosen to call our sister Dolores from this life to himself, we commit her to her final resting place, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his own in glory, for he has risen the firstborn from the dead. So let us now commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Amen. Friends, I just want to extend to you again an invitation to Lori's house immediately upon conclusion of this celebration. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful, and you are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. And may her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May Almighty God bless all of you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.